Fiesta. So, presentation and power system operation and control presented by R. Shranti. So, in DBS Institute of Technology. Okay. So, last class we discussed power system restructuring. Okay. So, and power system restructuring and major factors motivating and the restructuring and power exchange and independent system operator. Okay, so independent system operator and market operation and elastic and inelastic markets and market power and spot market and market clearing price. So, and now today our topic is standard cost. So the standard cost means the deterioration in the cost of electricity generation resources. Okay, so the deterioration in the cost of electricity generation resources due to restructuring of power industry is known as standard cost. Okay, so the deterioration in the cost of electricity generation resources restructuring of power industry is known as standard cost. The deregulation causes electricity prices. So the deregulation causes electricity prices to decline more than the production cost. Okay, so it will decline more than the production cost, which in turn reduce the earning of utilities and the cost of their goods. So the deterioration in the cost of electricity generation resources. The deterioration in the cost of electricity generation resources due to restructuring power industry is known as standard cost. So the deregulation causes electricity prices to decline more than the production cost, which in turn reduces the earning of utilities and cost of their goods. And next, transmission pricing. So transmission constraints prevents the operation of effective plants. Okay, so transmission constraints are prevents the operation of effective plants and after from fulfilling the revenue requirements. So after fulfilling the revenue requirement, transmission pricing should carry out the following functions. Okay, so transmission constraints prevents the operation of effective plants. So it will prevent the operation of effective plants. Okay, so after from fulfilling the revenue requirement, transmission pricing should carry out the following functions. First, to improve the effective day-to-day operation of bulk power markets. So for improving the effective day-to-day operation of bulk power market and to compensate owner of transmission resources and to compensate the owner of transmission resources and to be reasonable and practically implemented. So it will be reasonable and practically implemented to regain the operating and capital cost. So it will regain the operating and capital cost and to give a equal and a preference to all users. So it will give equal and preferences to all users. So to purpose an easy and understandable price structure. So transmission constraints prevents the effective plants. Okay, it will prevent the operation of transmission constraints prevents the operation of effective plants. So after fulfilling the revenue requirement, transmission pricing should carry out the following functions. Okay, so first one is to improve. So it will improve the effective day-to-day operation of bulk power markets. So it will improve the effectively day to day operation in bulky power market, and it will compensate the owner of transmission resources. So it will compensate owner of transmission resources, and it will be reasonably and practically implemented. So it will be reasonably and practically implemented, and to regain in the operating and capital cost. So it will regain the operating and capital cost, and to give equal preferences to all users. So it will give equal preferences to all users. So the purpose of an easy and understandable price structure. So the purpose is easy and understandable price structure. And next, conjunction pricing method. So in conjunction pricing method, by employing a suitable approaches, all restructuring schemes are considered conjunction cost into account in order to calculate the conjunction cost and assign these costs to the users of transmission system. Okay, so by employing suitable approaches of all restructuring schemes are considered as a conjunction cost into an account in order to calculate the conjunction cost. So, and to assign these costs are user transmission system. So if you want to calculate conjunction system, you want to assign these costs to be user transmission systems. Okay, so based on the following three basic methods, these approaches are evolved as follows. So based on the following, there are three basic methods. So these three approaches are evolved as cost of out and off merit dispatch. So cost of out, off merit dispatch, and locational marginal prices and usage charges of interzonal lines. Okay, so by applying suitable approaches of all restructuring schemes are considered as a conjunction cost. So in order to calculate the conjunction cost, it will be assigned the cost of user transmission system. Okay, so here three basic methods will be approaches that are cost of out and off merit dispatch. Cost of out, off merit dispatch, and locational marginal prices and usage charges of interzonal lines. Okay, so usage charges of interzonal lines. And next, coming to management of interzonal. So management of interzonal, the conjunctions which is primarily occurs on a transmission interfaces between the conjunction zones is known as interzonal conjunction. Okay, so the conjunction which occurs on transmission interfaces between the conjunction zones is known as interzonal conjunction. So it is a frequent and expensive with a widespread effect. Okay, so it is a frequent and expensive with a widespread effect. Okay, it is an objective to improve reliability and efficiency. Okay, so it is an objective to improve and to improve reliability and efficiency. Okay, so scheduling coordinates are charged extremely for using the interzonal interfaces depending upon the direction and opposite directions respectively. Okay, so here the scheduling coordinates are charged externally. Here scheduling coordinates are charged externally for using the interzonal interfaces. So interzonal interfaces depending upon the direction and opposite directions respectively. Okay, so next, conjunction costs are determined at marginal cost. So conjunction costs are determined at marginal cost and depending on the interface direction, all the SCs are charged or paid. Okay, here participating a transmission owners receive conjunction. Here participating transmission owners receive conjunction revenue, which affects on the next year SSP. Okay, so overall the management of interzonal means, so the conjunction which is primarily occurs on the transmission interfaces between conjunction. So conjunction which is primarily occurs on the transmission, primarily occurs on the transmission interfaces between the conjunction zones is known as interzonal conjunction, and it is a frequent and expensive. So it is a frequent and expensive with a widespread effect. So it is a frequent and expensive with a widespread effect. It is an objective to improve reliability and efficiency. Okay, it is an objective to improve reliability and efficiency. And scheduling coordinates are charged externally for using the interzonal interface. So here scheduling coordinates are charged externally for using interzonal interfaces depending upon the direction and opposite directions respectively. And next, conjunction costs are determined at marginal cost and depending on the interface direction. Here all SCs are charged or paid. Participation transmission owners receive conjunctions revenue which affect on the next year SSP. So next, interzonal conjunction. Interzonal conjunction means it is a frequent and inexpensive with a widespread effect. So it is a frequent and inexpensive with a widespread effect too. Okay, its objective is to improve reliability. Its objective is to improve reliability and it will holds the maximum customer choice. Okay, here scheduling coordinates are charged externally for using the intrazonal interference. Here scheduling coordinates are charged externally for using the intrazonal interfaces. Okay, so the conjunctions which occurs within a conjunction zones, a network constraints in it known as intrazonal conjunction. Okay, the conjunction is independent of the interface direction used by the SCs. Here the conjunction costs are determined as a bid and all SCs are charged depending in the demand in the zone. Okay, so PTOs do not receive the conjunction revenue and has no effect on next year SCs. Okay, so in intrazonal conjunction, so in intrazonal conjunction, infrequent and inexpensive. So in intrazonal conjunction, it is infrequent and inexpensive with a widespread effect. Okay, so with widespread effect, there are infrequent and inexpensive. Okay, so and its objectives is to improve, its objectives will improve the reliability and it will host the maximum customer choices. Okay, so next, scheduling coordinates are charged. Here scheduling coordinates are charged externally for using the intrazonal interference. Here scheduling coordinates are not charged externally for using the intrazonal interface. So it will not charged externally for using the intrazonal interference. So next, the conjunction which occurs, so the conjunction which occurs within a conjunction zone to a network constraints, it is known as intrazonal conjunction. So the conjunction which occurs within conjunction zones to a network constraints is known as intrazonal conjunction. Okay, the conjunction is independent of the interface direction used by, here the conjunction is independent of the interface direction used by SCs. Okay, here next,
The conjunction costs are determined as bid and all SEs are charged depending on the demand in the zone. Okay. Next, PTOs do not receive the conjunction revenues and has no effect on the next year SS. And coming to next, electricity price volatility.
Okay. So here, electric price volatility means volatility is the most disinfect of property of electricity, and price volatility is the most measure of instability in the electricity price. Is a specific period time. Okay. So volatility is the most disinfect property of electricity. So it will be most disinfect property of electricity price, and volatility is the most measure of instability in the electricity price in a specific period of time. Okay, so it is most disinfect period, and it will be measures in instability in electricity price. So in a specific period of time. Okay, and it is usually represented as percentage, and it is usually represented and in percentage and evaluated as the annualized standard deviation. So it will be evaluated as the annualized standard deviations of daily price percentage change. Okay, so usually represented as a percentage and evaluated as a annualized standard deviation of daily price percentage change. Okay, so it will be represented in percentages and evaluated as a annual standard deviation of daily price. So it will be evaluated annualized standard deviation of daily price percentages change. Okay, and it will depend on the time and may reflect the value of electricity derivatives like options and the futures. Okay, it will depend on the time and it will reflect the value of electricity derivatives. So it will reflect the value of electricity derivatives like options and futures. Okay, so the basic reason behind the electricity price volatility is to match the supply and demand on the second-by-second bias. Okay, so the basic reason behind the electricity price volatility is to match the supply demand and on a second-by-second basis. Okay, so this is a electricity price volatility. So the other reasons for electricity volatility means, so the other reasons volatility in fuel price. So now volatility in fuel price, uncertainty in load and uncertainty in generation and transmission conjunction, market participations in behavior and market operation, alternatives in hydroelectricity production. Okay, so the other reasons will be volatility in fuel price, uncertainty in load and uncertainty in generation. So volatility in fuel price, uncertainty in generation, uncertainty in load and transmission conjunction, and market participants behavior and market operation. So alternators in hydroelectricity productions. Next, electricity price index. So the movement. So here, the movement in prices are generally measured by a price index. Okay, movement of prices are generally measured in a price index. So Dow Jones indexes are used to analyze a price volatility. So Dow Jones indexes are used to analyze a price volatility. So these indexes defines the electricity prices for firm and non-firm sources. So and for on-peak and off-peak periods for some locations. Okay, so here these indexes defines the electricity prices for firm and non-firm sources, and for on-peak and off-peak periods of some locations. Okay, so the following are the Dow Jones daily electricity price indexes. So Dow Jones daily electricity price indexes are California Oregon border electricity price index and Palo Verde electricity price index and PJM seller choice price index and PJM Western Hub electricity price index and Mid Columbia electricity price index. Okay, so these and NP 15 electricity price index, these are the Dow Jones daily electricity price indexes. Okay, so California origin order price index, Palo Verde electricity price index, PJM seller's choice electricity price index and PJM Western Hub electricity price index, Mid Columbia electricity price index, NP 15 electricity price index. So these are Dow Jones daily electricity price index. So prices are generally measured by in price indexes. Those are Dow Jones indexes that is used in price volatility. Okay, so this is electricity price indexes. So thank you. So today we are ended standard cost and transmission pricing and conjunction pricing method and so electricity volatility. Okay, so the other reasons for electricity volatility. So these are all learned in today's class. Okay, thank you for everyone.